It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the Washington football team. Here we go, the final week of the NFL season, week 17, is underway. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. First and 10, Love looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
And 7 at the 28-yard line.
Here's Jordan Love. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. And he takes it all the way down to the 32. A big change in field position there. That's 40 yards on the catch and run. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Jones, first carry for the USC man. And he struggles to get a yard here, maybe a yard, down to the 31. Give him maybe a yard, quite the opposite from the previous big gainer. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Love. His throw caught right around the 6. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A good pickup there, 26 yards. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Only a yard that time. Second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
On the ground, it's Edmonds. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington.
Washington.
It's the fullback. His third touchdown now on the year. And Washington takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive. It's good, and Washington will take a 7-0 lead.
Washington 7, Eagles nothing.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. He'll drop the throw. This short throw caught by Goddard. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Miles Sanders, first carry of the game. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. Well, no slow start here. A couple nice chunk plays back to back.
I love the momentum that they're showing here early because they did it both ways, right? Threw the ball on first down for a nice chunk of yardage. Came right back and ran the ball. Looks like they've got the defense set back on their heels. Let's see if they can keep this moving.
As Sanders there with a first down carry that might have gotten a yard, if that. Second down.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Steps away to his left. And his throw is incomplete. He was trying to find DeSean Jackson that time. Third down here.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
From the gun, it's Hurts. Goodwin able to haul it in. And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Philadelphia.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Left side here to Sanders. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Boston Scott, his first carry. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line.
Chase Young.
Tackle made by Chase Young.
2 yards.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
On second down now, it's Scott. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
Montez Sweat brought him down. That's a gain of 3.
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. They'll break the huddle and come up on the 9th play of this drive, needing 5 yards on 3rd down. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Bit of a surprise, they ran it on 3rd and medium. Proved to be the right call. 1st and 10.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big 3rd down pickup to keep their drive alive.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only 1 yard on the pickup there. 2nd and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
2nd down. Here's Hurts. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Montez Sweat. Make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
They'll try to run with Sanders. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
A great job there by this defense. They give up the long drive, but in the end, it looks like they'll force a field goal attempt.
The kick by Elliott is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they get the field goal, but that is a 14-play drive to get three.
Sounds like you're going negative.
Sounds like
you think that three is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting a three is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get six out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if you guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
At the 25-yard line.
Second and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. This to McLaurin out on the left side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
16 yards.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
First down, going to the air with Love. And yet again, it's McLaurin. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. From the 47, it's second and 5. Love going to give this one to Jones. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
That's how you pick up a first down. You know where the sticks are. You know where the first down marker is. And you find a way to get there. That's called having vision.
He had a lot of vision last week, didn't he? NFC Offensive Player of the Week. He was dominant. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Rodney McLeod up to make the tackle.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find the hole.
4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Escaping the pressure right. He may try and run for this. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
And Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts.
It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Set, hunt.
first down carry by Jones. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It's a first down for Washington on a pickup of 11.
All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football from triple option, you've actually called that play.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll try and run it in with Jones. And he is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Ronald Jones, touchdown number 18 on the year.
And Washington going to add on to their lead.
He had the option to hand that football off. I think it's safe to say that he made the right decision. That was a heck of a run.
It certainly was. And when you mentioned the option, most people think the quarterback's not going to keep the ball. You know, in the NFL, that's usually not the recipe for being around too long. So when you do keep it, it often surprises the heck out of a defense.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
18-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Here's Hurts to throw. That's complete to a speedy wideout, Goodwin. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
A first and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost.
Trying for Sanders, but this is intercepted. Picked by Kendall Fuller, and he will bring this one back. It is a pick six for a Washington touchdown.
Tucker McCann.
And remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think this.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And they will finally put an end to the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line.
He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
Following the interception, Love. And that's going to be caught. Oh, a one-handed grab there. He's got it for the touchdown.
touchdown, Washington.
I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass his young quarterback throws and with the success that his team has had, I just continue to be more and more impressed.
Let's both do the analysis. Impressed, aren't we both?
Yeah.
I mean, and why shouldn't we be? We've seen him improve throughout the year. We've seen him settle in now, and you can see the confidence of the team has grown. His confidence has grown. I think that everyone around this guy feels good about what they've seen. And it's also safe for him when he's driving home to turn on Sports Talk Radio. He's okay.
At their own 25-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Well, look at the clock here. You're inside of a minute. First half hasn't gone that well for you. How are you going to play this drive?
Well, I've been told by my coaches previously that the intelligent approach, go ahead and run out the clock and start over. Don't make any more mistakes. But there's also something to understanding that you get this last drive here. You get the ball to start the second half. Try and go 2-for-1 here. Get some points now and come out of the locker room and get more points again and get your momentum really built up.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
33-yard line.
They'll throw now on the final play. Deep ball for Goodwin. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Fabian Moreau.
What are you doing?
So we've come upon halftime here in week 17 as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The final 2 quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of week 17 is underway. That'll be taken about a yard deep and beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
At their own 22-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 16 yards, a first down.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long. But nice throw there for a good gain and a first down.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
That's another Eagles first down. First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Clearly wasn't outside of the tackle box. There's your penalty.
And accompanying that penalty, a loss of down.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. They go play action with Hurts, rolling to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Rookie Jalen Reagor, the intended target that time. And that takes us from second to third down.
Third down and 20.
Here we go.
And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Washington defense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Mike, trap 60, trap 60.
Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. This short throw caught by Goddard. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down.
New Mike 52, Mike 52. Watch the run, Check 52 to Mike.
Hurts sets up to throw it. This is caught by Jackson. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Play action. Here's Hurts. And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags. And I believe this is going to be a first down. And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders, his 21st touchdown of the season. And the Eagles get a score closer. Coaches must really like to see that from the quarterback because he's had the interceptions in this game, but they're able to connect on the touchdown pass.
And teammates love to see that because they know that they miss blocks during a game, but they come back and make them later on. They miss tackles, right? They miss making plays, but the spotlight is magnified on your quarterback. And when he stands up to the pressure and comes back and throws a touchdown pass after throwing some picks earlier, they feel great about that guy.
And likewise for him personally, as a rookie quarterback, has to give him more confidence. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Washington 28, Eagles 9.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
They're on 25-yard line.
They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give them a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is, they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
Yeah, now they're just looking to add to that total. They'll run on first down. It's Jones.
Ronald Jones.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
At the 47-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
To throw now. Here's Love. Looking left sideline. It's complete. Touchdown, Washington. Terry McLaurin, his 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And Washington is able to stretch their lead. This offense, they were dynamic in the first half. The halftime break, that didn't slow them down at all. Big strike here in the third quarter.
It's almost as if they were saying, it's not just our skill in the first half is getting this done, it's confidence as well. And confidence has taken over this game in a big way. How about these strikes that we're seeing?
And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24.
Take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Eagles.
A gain of 13. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Sanders, and the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It was Deron Payne who got in there to make the play. 13 yards remaining on second down. Another run here with Sanders. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
He's across midfield to the 49-yard line. 12 yards on the play. Leads to third down and one.
They'll try and run for it with Sanders. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45.
That's good.
They're able to convert with a gain of four.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Throwing is Hurts. Quick catch, complete. It's Sanders. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down.
There's a nice pickup right there. And after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
Marquise Goodwin, incomplete. It's second down and 10.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. Flush to his right. This ball complete to Rager. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 9-yard line, 12-yard line. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love. Folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. And they'll get this out quickly to Goodwin. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
Second and 9 at the 11-yard line.
Focusing on me, from Tel Aviv. Barbados with the hustle, pockets, L.I.D.
Sanders here as they run out of the gun. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the five here as he's out at the six. And now Washington going to go ahead and use their final timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. The Eagles on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This is third and four. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. The kick by Elliott is good. And that'll put us within three scores as it becomes now a 23-point game. In the grand scheme of things, those 3 points likely not going to matter much, but I guess they get a little closer, a little more respectability.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been outplayed all game long, but like my mom used to tell me all the time before I went out, dress up a little bit, son. Make yourself respectable. And that's what they're doing here. They're just dressing up the final score.
They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. All of a sudden, they have quite a bit of breathing room. This was a one-score game, but touchdowns on their last two drives, and now comfort is here, so to speak.
It certainly is for them. I've been in this situation before on the flip side of this, and all that's going on there is a little bit of finger-pointing. Hey, what's going on? How can we stop them? Can someone make a play to try and stop this momentum?
Well, they're going
to
be ball-hawking because they need a turnover on that other side. Here's second and seven now from the 28. Working out of the gun, Love. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm, incomplete. Now it's third down. Defensively, celebration time because they finally forced an incompletion. He was perfect throwing the ball to that point.
Yeah, but from his viewpoint, they didn't force the incompletion. He just missed. That's how hot he is right now, and that's how he wants to continue to throw the ball.
On third down, Love. And he finds McLaurin. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Well, that's one way to convert on third down, picking up 26 yards.
And the Washington first down.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. Play fake. Here's Love. And looking for McLaurin, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD. Make it back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the groove, and what are the odds of what we're seeing right here? You don't see it happen very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season, it's been a big year, let alone back-to-back weeks. Tell you this, I wouldn't play cards against this guy in the locker room.
Well, it's still an uphill battle from here, that's for sure, but that makes it a two-score game.
And now we see why teams practice so much on the two-point conversion, why you have more than one play ready, because you may need multiples throughout a ball game. There's a great example right there.
And this one travels out of bounds, so unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. Give it to the first option. That's their fullback.
And he's got this down to the 35. It'll go as a pickup of 14 and a Washington first down.
This is where, you know, fourth quarter, you got the lead, you give it to the big guy. Defensively, kind of sucks the will out of them, doesn't it? Because they don't want to tackle him right now this late in the game.
But you say that with accusatory tones. I mean, you know, but you're exactly right. I know it's not something.
And the ball comes out. Love lost it. And the Eagles have recovered. Holding on to the football, becoming a little bit of an issue. He had two fumbles last week, remember?
I played for a guy that used to talk all the time about creating turbulence in the pocket, making the quarterback jumpy, make him antsy, keep getting after him a little bit, and make sure he thinks about holding on to the ball because you're going after him.
But first down, Hurts. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Troy Apke. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Boy, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference, meet it head on, and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity.
Washington.
Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and 10. On play action, Love to throw. Slings this deep for McLaurin. It's caught inside the 25. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21.
6 yards on the play. And the Washington first down.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10.
Now Love. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
Was trying to get it to Terry McLaurin, and it's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces, and I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And it's knocked away and incomplete.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
So with that, you figure, yeah, this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down. But don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And the complexion of this one has really changed a fair amount. That last field goal makes it a three-score game, so they need points in a hurry with time dwindling in the fourth quarter.
And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
From the gun, it's Hurts. This short throw caught by Goddard. And again, gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. That'll be caught, Rager with it. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
And now here is another interception. Picked by Kendall Fuller, and he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line. And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, 5 interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a 5th interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously... And looking for McLaurin, but this is intercepted. Picked off near the 29. And he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
This short throw caught by Goddard. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback, a hot route, so to speak.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Montez Sweat, and they're going to be staring at a 3rd and long here.
Brings up 3rd down.
Pass the 60. Pass the 60. Choose the ball. Hey, check, check.
Here's Hurts to throw. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go. Ronald Darby that time, the one who got a hand in and knocked it free. Here's Cameron Johnston now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And how about this? A fake. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. So it's Washington getting the victory here, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing three turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean